Good evening. It's a great pleasure to be here to play for you. And we have some music that we particularly love ahead, starting with music of Beethoven. I discovered on some social media site today that today is the anniversary of the premiere of the Ninth Beethoven Symphony, which was on May 7th in 1824. So there's another anniversary to mention too. That's when Brahms comes up later. But we will be starting with Beethoven, not the Ninth Symphony, a piece that he wrote somewhat earlier than the Ninth Symphony. It's his third sonata, the sonata in A major, opus 69, for cello and piano, or actually as published for piano and cello. I know Steve likes that. Right. But actually, it's the first of the five sonatas. There are two early ones and two late ones, and this one falls in the middle, where the parts are actually pretty well distributed between the instruments. So it's a very sort of conversational, duo-centric piece. It's always a great treat to play. The first movement is a very sort of broad, beautiful movement marked Allegro Monon. What is it? Allegro Monon Tanto. I should memorize these sorts of things. It's in a sort of what we would call sonata form. There's an exposition. There's a big development section, and then there's a recap. You'll hear when the opening material comes back about 2/3 of the way through the movement. Then a scherzo movement, a very fast presto scherzo, that is in a form that Beethoven sort of well, he championed, and I'm not sure other composers really did it very often, and that is the five-part scherzo. So it's the first part, a contrasting trio section, first part comes back, contrasting trio section again, and then the first part comes back for the fifth section. So I think you'll be able to follow that little path as we play through the scherzo movement. Then, instead of writing an entire slow movement, Beethoven wrote basically two beautiful phrases that could have been developed into a slow movement, but he chose not to do that. Instead, he treats them as an introduction to the final movement, a very lively movement that also is in a sonata form, as I mentioned at the beginning about the first movement. So you'll have this exposition section, a clear developmental section, and then the opening material comes back again. So it's basically a three-movement form with a scherzo in the center, and Beethoven A major, third sonata, opus 69.
Thank you.
So today is the 189th anniversary of Brahms' birth. Happy birthday, Brahms. And we did not plan this program knowing that. Another discovery on social media for me today. You see, my social media followings are very dull. It's all classical music and passenger trains and things like that. And food, too, by the way. But I did not realize that Brahms' birthday was the 7th of May, and now maybe I'll never forget that, and neither will you. So we're excited to play for you today a piece written in 1886 by Brahms. It's his second sonata for, well, it probably says piano and cello. Oh, maybe it doesn't say. Cello and piano. It's the sonata in F major. Now, those of you who know the E minor sonata and don't know this piece, you're in for quite a surprise, because this is a very, very different kind of piece. As you may know, the E minor sonata starts with a low register cello part, sort of slowly paced. Piano part is sort of accompanimental, this sort of thing. Well, this is so different in the sense that, it starts off with a bang. I mean, it's almost like he's writing orchestral parts in the piano. And this kind of fragmented thematic writing that he likes to do in a lot of his works, as a matter of fact, like for example, the Fourth Symphony. But it's an interestingly compact work, and I have found that a number of pieces that Brahms wrote later in his life are this way, more sort of direct, shorter phrases, shorter sections, shorter piece. This is the four-movement piece that's not much more than 20 minutes, probably. So as opposed to some of his earlier works, which are much more sort of, I don't want to say long-winded, but long, and you know, big singing sort of rich phrases and this sort of thing. So you're in for a surprise if you don't know it. It is a very interesting, lively, energetic piece, as I mentioned, in F major. First movement, of course, is in F major. Second movement, interestingly, he goes up half a step to F sharp major and writes one of his most beautiful, I think, and heartfelt slow movements, followed by a very lively scherzo with a contrasting trio section. And then finally, the last movement, he kind of goes back to perhaps a simpler time. It's kind of a movement that seems very much based on kind of folk tunes, folk melodies, kind of a simple, beautiful, naturally sort of flowing tune that sets the stage for the last movement. So I hope you enjoy F major, Brahms, Sonata, Opus 99.
Thank you.
we have a couple more short pieces for you. The second has never before been heard by human ears. Well, that's not really true, but it has rarely been played. I'll tell you about that in a second. In fact, the arrangement of the piece we're about to play has rarely been done, as far as I know. This is a piece by Erich Wolfgang Korngold. When he was about 20, he wrote an opera called Die Todstadt, The Dead City. And there are some very famous arias from that opera that we hear from time to time. Often Marietta's Lied we listen to. The other that we often encounter is the Tanzlied of Pierrot, who is one of the characters in the opera. It's the dance song from Pierrot. At a certain point in the opera, he's asked to sing a song, and he sings a very sentimental, sort of nostalgic piece that is essentially a waltz. So that's hence the title, Tanzlied. And this is an arrangement that, as far as I know, Korngold made for cello or for violin and piano. So this is the Tanzlied of Pierrot. It's called Mein Sehnen, Mein Wannen, and perhaps the first time heard in this hall or even in Mountain View.
Thank you.
a surprise. Except it won't be a surprise for long. How many of you are fans of Broadway tunes? What about old Broadway tunes from like, what, 1930s, would you say, Steve?
I think
this is 40s. 40s. Specifically, My Fair Lady. Okay. It's one of two shows that I've played in my life while in high school. So many years ago, Steve Prutsman made arrangements of several Broadway tunes for cello and piano. And this is one of them. And I think you'll recognize it, but I'll just tell you it's called I Could Have Danced All Night. What's surprising about it is not just what the piece is, but what Steve's creative brain has done with it. So enjoy. You'll hear some I Could Have Danced All Night that you would recognize and other bits that might surprise you.
Thank you. Thank you.